What are your strengths? It's a high-stakes question. If you can make the interviewer see your strengths and understand why they're uniquely suited to the role, it can significantly advance you toward landing the job. But we're always worried about talking about the wrong strength or talking about the right strength in a way that feels over the top. That's why I went to the Indeed Career Coaches to get some information on what interviewers want to hear when they ask this question, how to identify the best strengths to share in an interview, and a really cool strategy for talking about your gifts in a way that's professional and confident. Oh, be sure to stick around to the end for a list of strengths you definitely should not share in an interview. By knowing what not to say, you can rise above the competition. All right, so let's get started by figuring out why interviewers ask this question in the first place and what they want to hear you say. When a hiring manager asks about your strengths, they want to hear three key things. First is that you have the self-awareness to reflect on your performance in the workplace. So basically, you know what your strengths are, point blank. Second is that you have proof to back up those claims. You can explain why your strengths really are your strengths. And then third is why these qualities innately prepare you for success in the role. So you know your strengths, you can prove that you have them, but why do they matter when we're talking about them in the context of this job interview? Now, even if you aren't directly asked about your strengths, look for opportunities to showcase them. In every interview, your goal is, of course, to demonstrate your skills and experiences that are most relevant and compelling for the role. Sometimes people think that the smartest approach to answering this question is simply to repeat the ideal qualities that a candidate would have as listed in the job description. While there's a part of that that is really on track, you do want to consider not just what strengths you have, but which strengths are most relevant for the role. It can actually come across as inauthentic. And if an employer asks you, oh, well, tell me about a time when you demonstrated that strength, you might not have anything substantive to say. So I have a strategy from the Indeed Career Coaches that can help you approach this in a way that's both strategic and sincere. Rather than running to the job description, step one of this strategy is to reflect inward and identify your true strengths. So the goal here is to brainstorm, make a long list that we can whittle down later. So just go ahead and figure out your superpowers. Ask yourself the question of, what am I really good at? What do I have to offer? When you're figuring out your strengths, sometimes it can be helpful to go through categories. So I have a few categories of strengths here. First is experience. Basically, do you have a lot of time working in a certain industry, a lot of experience working in a certain task or with a certain skill? Do you have a particular niche of customers or technology that you've worked with in the past? Second is soft skills. So these are skills that basically impact how we do our work. Are you great at managing people? Are you great at leadership skills? Are you a strong negotiator? Are you really organized? Great time manager. Then there's hard skills. These are more task oriented. So do you have a language fluency? Are you a great computer programmer? Are you a copywriter? Anything that actually enables you to do a particular task, that's a hard skill. And then finally is education and training. Do you have an educational background or degrees that really prepare you for success or expertise in this field? This can be everything, like I said, from college degrees to special certifications or even relevant internships from back when you were in school. If you're feeling stuck, try expanding beyond your own perspective. Check out old performance reviews or feedback from your peers praising your work. If there's any repeating themes there, consider that as a possible strength. Alternatively, if you haven't been in a work environment yet, think about what your professors or peers have said in regards to your former work, or think about past internships. By starting from this reflective, authentic place, you're demonstrating sincerity and self-awareness, which is already a cut above other candidates who haven't done this exercise. Now I'm going to explain how to narrow down that list and identify the best strengths to mention in the interview. But before I do, if you've watched this far, please hit the like button and subscribe to us down below. And don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that you can get notified every time we post new career advice. All right, let's move on to the next tip. Step two is to prioritize the strengths you mentioned based on their relevancy to the role. Now that we have this long list of brainstormed strengths from step one, we're trying to figure out, how do I prioritize what I mention to an employer? What's going to be most compelling to them? And obviously, now this is when we return back to the job description. We see the list of strengths and the qualities they're looking for from a candidate, and then we compare that to our list, and then we see about the overlap there. If there's overlap, great. You can already more authentically and persuasively speak about those strengths because they came from you and you have stories and things to back them up. However, if you don't have a ton of overlap, or if you think, there's this quality that I have that they don't explicitly say they're looking for, but I think is really important to the role, great. I really recommend that you mention that. And I do so because most candidates will just simply go to that original list and regurgitate what are the qualities in the job description. So if you can think creatively about the unique value that you can offer, and sometimes even say, hey, possible employer, I know you didn't mention that this is something that you needed, but I actually think you really need it and I have it. That's pretty persuasive and is a much more authentic and sometimes distinguishing offering than candidates who just focus on the overlap. So, highly recommend you to think creatively about what's really necessary for success in this role. So with this in mind, hone that long list of brainstorm strengths down to the three that you feel are most impactful and relevant to the role, with the understanding that you'll likely only be asked to talk about one. Step three is to specify. So now that you have the relevant strengths that you know you're going to talk about, really consider strategically the language that you are going to use to describe them. If your answer is yes, when you ask yourself, could most people say this thing about themselves? Then it's time to pick another strength. So, for example, instead of people skills, go with something more descriptive or unique, like client management, relationship building, or conflict resolution. By honing in on what the exact thing is that you're great at, you're going to have a more unique and clear professional offering to distinguish yourself from other candidates, and your employer is going to have a more concrete idea of how you'll exactly use the skill to succeed in the role. All right, step four is to prepare to demonstrate. So now we know what our strengths are, we know the specific language we're going to use to describe them, but that's not enough. If you're gonna lay claim to a strength, had better be able to back it up. And rather than just telling why you think you have that strength, it's really great if you can show that you have that strength by telling a really compelling story to the employer. So, when it comes to storytelling in an interview, there's a whole bunch of techniques that people use, but the one that we recommend is called the STAR technique, or STAR technique. That just means you describe the situation you were in, the task you had or what you felt you had to do, the action you took, and the result you achieved. Kind of a lot, I know, but basically, what was the situation? What did you do about it? And so what, or what was the impact? If you want more information on structuring your answers in an interview, I highly recommend you check out this video right here on behavioral interviewing. Step five is to emphasize impact. Impact is actually the most important component of your response, because when an employer asks to hear about your strengths, they're not just wanting to know, okay, what are your strengths and give me an example to prove that you really have them. They're wanting to know, how will this person's strengths help my company succeed? In order to know whether or not you are demonstrating convincing impact, try asking yourself the question, so what? Okay, so you may have been successful as a result of your strength in your past job. So what for the new employer? You need to make sure that you make the connection between this strength and how it's going to benefit the company. So get specific about team goals, about company OKRs, about any details that you can concretely tie to how this is going to really benefit the employer. I have an example impact statement written down here. So a great impact statement could be, my history of high quality project management will fully set me up for entering the startup environment where new programs seek rapid growth but don't have any structure in place. These big ambitions require thoughtful organization, which is something I have proven experience in developing. Pro tip, rambling here can actually make you seem more nervous than you really are. It's recommended that your answer is 1 to 2 minutes when you're talking about your greatest strengths. For more tips on how to seem really confident and composed in an interview, I recommend checking out this video right here. Now, as promised in the beginning, let's talk about what you should avoid when talking about your strengths and even specific strengths that you shouldn't mention. There are three common mistakes that people make when discussing their strengths in an interview. Mistake one is lacking self-awareness. It takes a lot of insight and thoughtfulness to understand the strengths that you have. It actually shows that you're reflective and deliberate about the way you approach your work. If you're searching for answers or don't have anything sincere or unique to say, it can actually make you seem unsure of yourself. Mistake number two is selling yourself short. Many candidates aren't comfortable talking about their greatness. It can feel sort of cheesy to try and sell yourself, or maybe you're introverted and this kind of discussion is really uncomfortable. First off, now is the time to brag. You're in an interview, so do your best to feel comfortable discussing what you're really good at. However, I know that's a lot easier said than done, so I do have a quick tip here, which is if you're uncomfortable in the situation, try to show rather than tell. Really lean into those examples. Rather than feeling like, oh, I'm being pretentious or weird by laying claim to this strength and saying that I have it, just state it simply and then spend most of your time talking about the past actions that you took to back that up and letting your behavior speak for itself. Mistake number three is choosing ordinary strengths. Remember, don't pick a strength that most people could lay claim to. In this case, rarity and scarcity creates value and sort of a unique professional offering. If they want someone who has that, they need to come to you. For example, a strength to avoid saying is being a hard worker. Well, that might be true and is certainly admirable. There's nothing uniquely desirable about it. Instead, you can say that you are relentless in pursuit of a deadline, that you are volunteering constantly to take on new projects, or that you are eager to pursue solutions and are a great problem solver in order to rise to any occasion. All of those things are much more specific than just being a hard worker. All right, let's quickly recap how to answer what are your strengths. Step one is to identify your authentic and sincere strengths. Taking a look at performance feedback can be a great place to start. Two is to narrow that list down to the three strengths that are most relevant to the role. And don't be afraid to go beyond the job description by thinking critically about what can you offer this job or company that would be really valuable. Three is describe those strengths using specific language. Remember that scarcity is valuable. Four is to demonstrate your strengths through stories of success. Lean into that STAR response method. Five is to emphasize impact. How was this strength useful to your former employer, and how will it be an asset to your future one? And six, demonstrate self-awareness, sell yourself, and really hone in on your unique professional offering. If you found this video helpful, please let us know by hitting the like button down below. Subscribe to our channel right here. For more interviewing advice, check out this playlist up here. There's a ton of videos there to help you out. And if you'd like another video on how to answer a particularly tricky interview question, tell me about yourself, check out this video right here. All right, I hope you found this helpful, and I will see you next time.